So today we are going to start a new topic called as from 12th standard syllabus. It is nothing but the human reproduction. This chapter has more weightage in your NEET paper also. So that is why I started, and if at all you are planning to get into medicine, like for doing your MBBS also, this chapter will be of great help. So let me start with human reproduction. So first of all, what is reproduction? In what way the reproduction is unique? Okay, well, how is that mechanism so unique? Is that, as you all know, reproduction is a process in which, the process of giving life to young ones, giving birth to young ones. So, reproduction, the ability to reproduce, will govern the age of that particular species. For example, if a man is getting older, how will you know that he's getting older? Is his reproductive ability will decrease. So, that is the main thing. So reproduction is more associated with the age. So it is an age-based factor. It's an age-based process. So now, in the human reproduction, we'll be seeing about the entire male reproductive system, female reproductive system, gametogenesis, fertilization, development. So from A to Z, from sperm, ovum, till the formation of the baby, we'll be seeing the entire thing. So now, to start with the processes, I would like to highlight on the processes. And then I would like to go in detail about the structure. The process of formation of gamete is called as gametogenesis. So when I say genesis, genesis is the process of formation. So the process of formation of gametes is called as gametogenesis. This can be of two types. One is spermatogenesis, formation of sperm, and the other one is oogenesis, formation of ovum. So gametogenesis can be of two types, spermatogenesis and oogenesis. So after gametogenesis, what happens is, after the maturation of the gametes, the fertilization will happen, right? So fertilization. So after fertilization, what happens is, so if at all there is a fertilization, you cannot say the woman is pregnant, okay? So there should be a very, very, very important step which is successful, which is nothing but the implantation. So we'll see about all these things later, but I'm just telling you what the how is the flow. Implantation is a process of attachment of the fertilized zygote in the wall of uterus. So you cannot say once the zygote is formed, the woman is pregnant. No, it should go and attach itself to the wall of the uterus, and that process is called as implantation. Then following the implantation, what happens is the baby grows and develops, right? So there will be a complete formation of organs and other things. So what happens is organogenesis, embryogenesis, organogenesis, okay, embryo, it starts as embryogenesis and ends up in the organogenesis, and the complete fetus is formed. Lastly, parturition. Parturition, or it is also called as childbirth. Parturition or childbirth. So this is the last. So it starts from the gamete, fertilization, implantation, organ formation, embryogenesis fully, then parturition or childbirth. Okay. So now what we are going to see everything step by step, and the number of months the mother is holding the baby, that period is called as gestation period. That is right from fertilization till parturition, the entire period is called as gestation period. So in humans, it is normally 10 months, 9 to 10 months is the gestation period. But this will vary from one individual to other individual. So this is all about the introduction. So as a first step, we are going to start with the male reproductive system. We'll be seeing about male reproductive organs and everything. So male reproductive system. So I'm going to split the entire system into on three heads. One is the structure of testis. Next will be the accessory ducts. The last one will be the glands associated. So this is how I'm going to split the entire topic. Now, to start with, let's start with the structure of testis. So as you all know, testis, the reproductive organs are located in the pelvic region. Okay, both for male and female, they're located in the pelvic region. Now, there are a pair of testes, one on either side of the abdominal cavity. Okay, so every person will have two testes, okay, one on either side of the abdominal cavity. Each testis is externally covered by a, you see this is a testis, it is externally covered by a very thick covering or a bag-like structure called as scrotum. So what is the scrotum? Is a very thick covering of the testis, because testis and for the production of the sperms, which is happening inside the testis, the temperature has to be maintained. Okay, so what happens, there should not be any raise in the temperature. Okay, so for that maintenance of the temperature, testis is externally covered by a very, very thick covering called a scrotum. So inside the scrotal sac, the testis are embedded. When you see the cross section of the testis, each testis is divided into lot of tiny, tiny lobules called as testicular lobules. So each testis has got lot of tiny, tiny lobules or compartments called as testicular lobules. Okay, inside the testicular lobules, what happens is there are lot of coiled tubes called as seminiferous tubules. So I repeat, if you see the cross section of the testis, I'll have lot of lobules called testicular lobules. Each testicular lobules will have lot of seminiferous coiled tubules called as seminiferous tubules. For example, imagine I'm magnifying this coiled tube. So this is my seminiferous tubule. Okay, so now the actual production of the sperm happens inside the seminiferous tubules. Okay, so if you can see here, seminiferous tubules, inside the seminiferous tubules, there are two types of cells. Okay, one is inside, see, I'm talking about a testis, inside the testis, lobules, inside the lobule, seminiferous tubule, and inside the seminiferous tubule, there are two types of cells. One is male sperm cell or spermatogonia. So as the name says, from this cell only the sperms are being produced. Okay, so spermatogonia or sperm mother cell. Next one is cerituli cells. So I repeat, inside the seminiferous tubule there are two types of cells. One is male germ cells or spermatogonia, and the other one is cerituli cells. So as I told you, this male germ cells will undergo a process called as meiosis and they will become the sperm. Whereas cerituli cells, what are the function is, they will nourish, they will supply nutrition for the developing sperm cells. So they are nutritious in nature. Supply nutrition. So these two type of cells are found inside the seminiferous tubule. Now, if you can see, there are many seminiferous tubule like this. Okay, so the gap between, but there might be little gap here and there like this. I'll use the other color. So between the seminiferous tubules, you can find some gap, right? So this gap, for example, here, you can find some gaps between the tubules. So this gap is filled with a, This gap is filled with a special type of cells called as Leydig cells. Leydig cells or interstitial cells. So this gap is covered by a special type of cells called as Leydig cells. But this is outside the seminiferous tubule. These two are inside the seminiferous tubule, whereas this is outside the seminiferous tubule. So this, what is the function of the Leydig cells is, the Leydig cells will secrete a secondary male hormone or secondary hormone responsible for secondary sexual characters of the male, which is called as androgen. Androgen. So androgen is a hormone which is secreted by the Leydig cells present in between the seminiferous tubule. So overall, I have three types of cells: male germ cells, Sertoli cells, and Leydig cells. So these are all the types of cells which are present inside the testis. So now, with this note, what we are going to see next is the accessory ducts present in the testis. So first of all, why do we need a duct? Because sperms are produced in the testis. Okay. So from there, the sperms should reach the male copulatory organ, which is nothing but the penis. Okay. So from there only, the sperms will be traveling to the female genital tract. So to reach from the testis to the male copulatory organ, that is nothing but the penis, I need a proper channel or a duct, correct? So that ducts are the ones which we are going to see now. So this is my testis. Okay. So from here, the duct arises. And this is connected to the okay. So this is the testis. From here, the ducts are arising. So you'll have four names for the ducts. Okay. So which I'll teach you first and then tell you where it comes. First is reti. Testis. Next, vasa efferentia. Next is epididymis. The last one is vas deferens. So these are all the parts. Okay, so I repeat, always remember, two V's will not come closer. Okay. So vasa reti testis, vasa efferentia, epididymis, and vas deferens. So these are all the parts of the other parts of your accessory ducts. Now, the junction at which the tube is immediately leaving your testis over here. So this portion is called as reti testis. Immediately, as soon as it leaves the testis, it is called as reti testis. And then this portion, okay, from the coil before that, this portion is called as vasa efferentia. The coiled portion is called as epididymis. And after the coiled portion, there's a long slender tube, and that is called as vas deferens. So the order is reti testis, vasa efferentia, epididymis, and vas deferens. So the sperms which are produced from the seminiferous tubules over here are carried down through reti testis, through vasa efferentia to epididymis and vas deferens. So from vas deferens, it will reach the male copulatory organ. Why is this epididymis coiled? Is that epididymis will store the sperms temporarily, because during copulation, sperms are not produced instantly. They are already produced and they are stored here. So when there is a need, the ejection of sperms will happen from here and the production will start. It will keep on going. Okay. And from here, the ejection of the sperms will be happening. So what happens is, the sperms are temporarily stored in the epididymis. And if epididymis is like full, then it moves on to vas deferens. So this is all about the structure of testis and accessory ducts associated with the